I think I figured out finally what is wrong with the 220-gallon reef tank, and it is totally not what we expected. I know I've been gone a really, really long time, and I left y'all on the biggest cliffhanger ever, but I really needed to take a break from social media. I was feeling super overwhelmed with everything that's going on in both my life and in the hobby with my tank, so I kind of just needed a little pause there. So as you guys know, I've had a lot of issues with my 220 gallon reef tank recently, to say the least, right? Started off with my chato oddly withering away, and I thought it was because of my refugium light schedule, which for some reason was set on the wrong settings. It was set on something for corals. So I thought, hey, okay, you know, whatever. But then I also started to get some macro deaths, and this was absolutely devastating. It happened on Christmas. I was very distraught. And I never really narrowed down the problem behind what happened, but I did figure out that my nitrate and phosphate were super low. Like, Salifert detects nitrate and phosphate at zero low. So I suspected that this had to be the cause behind all of the chaos. But contrary to all logic, the water changes I did during this time surprisingly helped. And a few of y'all mentioned in the comments that something's off here, something's whack, because they actually help. The water changes actually help. This is totally weird if you're having low nutrient problems, right? Because it shouldn't be helped by a water change at all. So all this is looking really sus, you know. Since my last video, I have been, you know, not thinking that nitrate and phosphate is the problem here, because, you know, the problem didn't even seem to be getting much better despite the actions I had taken to increase the nutrients coming into the tank, feeding more refroids, being dumped in the tank, you know, etc. And gradually, as the days went by, though, the water started becoming more and more cloudy. More and more cloudy. And then it clicked. It clicked. It's a bacteria bloom in the water column. A bacteria bloom in the freaking water column, y'all. That would really explain things, right? I mean, the bacteria bloom was hurting all of my corals and sucking up all of the nutrients. I mean, right? But now I'm even more confused. Because you see, this isn't the first water column bacteria bloom that I've had with this tank. A little bit of a story time here. About 6 months ago, I also had a bacteria bloom, and it scared me to death because I've never actually dealt with one before. And it really truly was a traumatic chain of events, honestly. My tank water started becoming cloudy and the corals became really angry. So at that point, I did get a UV sterilizer. And I set it in this temporary position on the side of my tank and use this little pump, this little C-shaped pump to, you know, pump it through. And the water cleared up really quickly and the corals bounced back happy as Larry, which is good, obviously. But it was a bit of a dramatic time afterwards, after the fact, trying to reconfigure my light schedule. You know, UV sterilizers mean crystal clear water, which is all well and good, but with a lowish nutrient load, that water becomes really crystal clear, really crystal clear water. My corals were obviously not going to enjoy that, and I was a bit nervous about changing up the light schedule too much, but all was well. No losses at this point. No losses at this point 6 months ago. But the low nutrients meant my corals, especially my SPS at the time, were not all that bright and colorful, but they gradually did color back up, and the tank was really shaping up. It was looking good. And just when, ironically enough, I started to become really proud of my growth and coloration, bam, here we are yet again. Here we are today, yet another bacteria bloom. When it happened the first time, I was way more understanding. You know, fairly new tank. This stuff happens, you know, not enough, you know, good bacteria in the tank. You know, okay, we'll deal with it, right? Now a little bit year in, what is going on, y'all? What is going on? I am scratching my head about what the cause is. I mean, yet again, I mean, something is fueling this bacteria bloom, you know? The only thing that would really cause this bacteria bloom is an accidental addition of a carbon source. I mean, something is adding carbon to my tank. The only thing I can think of is that maybe some vinegar got into the tank from cleaning my glass. Maybe. But honestly, that's a bit too much of a stretch for a whole bacteria bloom in the column. I think it's it's a bit too much of a stretch for my liking. This is all very strange. Very, very strange. And I'm still on edge and I'm still super stressed out and I just haven't really been able to look at my tank since. Now that we've established that it's a bacteria bloom, my UV sterilizer is hooked up again and the water is clear. The corals seem to be recovering okay. The SBS that are left are coming back. My LPS were always fine because, you know, LPS. And I got my ICP tests. I have to submit them here in a few days. And when the results come in, we're gonna look at that together and we're gonna figure out what the heck is the situation on this tank. I am so frustrated. Truly, I'm questioning the hobby, you know? Is a hobby really supposed to drive you crazy? I mean, isn't that like not the point, you know? It'll be really interesting to do that ICP test though. You know, I've never actually done one before, so it should be fun, should be exciting. What else? I've been really generous with my fish feeding and adding reefroids in a couple of times a week. I've kind of stopped doing that. I keep my skimmer on now, but I do not have plans to restart that refugium anytime soon. It's just not necessary. I thought it was really funny when a few of y'all pointed out in my comments that why did you even start the refugium in the first place, Stephanie? And I mean, I agree. Like I literally started the refugium for no good reason. Just that, oh, I should have a refugium in this area. Totally backwards logic. And I can't believe I even thought that. Like it's so embarrassing, you know? Like I would never give that advice, you know? So I don't know why I gave that own advice. Like I proceeded that way and did things that way. Don't ask me why, but that's what happened. And I did order pre-quarantined fishies, y'all. I ordered pre-quarantined fishies. I did record the process, but then lost my SD card, which was really annoying. The quarantine fishies have arrived. Unfortunately, one did not make it in the QT process. I did get a copper band, but I was refunded on that. Hopefully I'll get my copper band one day soon. But these few little additions arrived. I have three lyretail anthias, one male and two females. Honestly, they're gorgeous. They're eating straight out of the bag, you know, of course, because anthias are fatties, and they're really beautiful, really healthy, just gorgeous fish. I'm waiting for the male to color up a bit more, but even he's already sexy. I mean, he's a big fellow too. He's quite a big fellow. Anyway, they've made really great additions. I love them. I love them. I love them. I'm generally a really big fan of anthias now, and I do want to add more in the future, maybe once things settle down more. I also still regrettably depend on my water changes, but I'm going to do the aminos here soon. I really hate doing those water changes. I really, if I could like cut that back to like every 2 weeks, I would be really happy. You know, I have some Seachem aqua vitro fuel that I plan to use. I did use this in my 40 gallon a while back and I do really love it. I accidentally caught the smallest size from Amazon. So gotta get more of that, you know, but yes, trying to figure out the root cause of my bacteria bloom here. It's gone away. And honestly, I fear that it would come back if I were to take off that UV sterilizer. So my plan moving forward is to definitely attach that UV permanently. And I would not be the one to do that typically, but this, I'm sick of this. I am at the end of my stick here with this hobby. And if that means that I have to install a UV sterilizer permanently, that's what we got to do, y'all. That's what we got to do. I mean, I'm still really devastated. I honestly can't look at my tank. I mean, I take care of it, do the water changes, but I'm not looking at my tank with fascination and with love and with, you know, curious eyes. I am no longer doing that. I'm honestly, frankly, depressed. That's what took me so long to record this video and get back on YouTube. I don't know. I'm really having a hard time looking at my tank still. So hopefully this stuff can clear up soon and I can fall in love with the hobby again. I apologize I couldn't respond to everybody's comments in the last video. I mean, y'all really helped me out there. I was really kind of overwhelmed at the time after posting that video because it was still kind of happening in real time, but I did read every comment and everyone's advice was really useful. It made me think a lot about the situation a bit differently. So thank you, y'all. I always appreciate your advice. And if y'all have any other tips on bacteria blooms, what could possibly be the cause behind having a bacteria bloom at a year in, and am I missing something? You know, am I missing something? What carbon source could be entering into my tank at this point in time? You know, I'm driving myself crazy. I really hate having problems with my tank. So send me all of the good vibes that you can. I really need the good vibes, y'all. I need those good vibes.